Spinosaurus is a truly amazing dinosaur. It's big, it's really specialized, really well adapted to a different way of life than any other giant creature, and it's just plain weird looking. It certainly is one of the great stars in the history of dinosaurs. If I heard that there was a living Spinosaurus today, I would be there in a flash. I would love to see what this creature actually was like, moving around, looking for food, just even standing there. To see such a creature unlike anything around today, would just be phenomenal. It was a giant. It was the biggest of the meat-eating dinosaurs we know about. It had a long skull with big crocodile-like teeth. It had massive arms with huge claws. And it had these really weird, elongate spines coming out of its back to form a sail or a fin, things that make it distinctive compared to all the other giant dinosaurs. Look at those teeth. How are they shaped? How would those teeth pierce through flesh? Look at those jaws. How do those arms operate? How deeply could those claws penetrate? What we do know about Spinosaurus is that it was weird and it was big. Since there are only a few bits and pieces known from the original Spinosaurus, it's pretty difficult to put it together. What we need is a link. What we need is something to tie those pieces together. The claws and hands of Spinosaurus, honest to goodness, are like industrial meat hooks. If you were to go to a slaughterhouse or a butcher's shop, that's where you would see their modern equivalent. All those long spines together form this big sail or fin on the back. It's a narrow structure. What's it for? Spinosaurus lived in an environment with extremely large plant-eating dinosaurs that may have been a major food source. But it was competing for this food source against some pretty tough customers. Resurrecting a dinosaur like Spinosaurus is pretty difficult, especially when the first specimen was destroyed and we can't even use those original bones. They're cone-shaped teeth, 6, 8, 10 inches long, possibly longer, sticking out of tremendously powerful jaws, really, really nasty weapons of destruction. When Spinosaurus got its jaws onto its victim, it would pierce through the meat with those conical teeth. It would thrash its skull back and forth, yanking out chunks of meat, and as it's thrashing back and forth, that victim's neck could be broken. So between the meat being pulled out and the thrashing back and forth, that victim would not last very long. Today's big land predators are things like polar bears and grizzly bears and Siberian tigers, and all of them have some pretty impressive claws, claws that can make short work of a human being like us. But those claws are pathetic against the gigantic talons of Spinosaurus. The loss of the original Spinosaurus fossil was a great tragedy for science. And so, for many decades, we've missed what it is that makes Spinosaurus so interesting because we couldn't look at its bones. A structure like a sail gives a huge surface area without much addition of volume. It can remove heat. It could show off against maybe other Spinosaurs, maybe in tests of showing off which is the better Spinosaurus, which is the dominant one, which one gets all the girls or whatever it is. We don't know this for certain, and it will take some detailed anatomical work to demonstrate those pits are the same thing as the pits in crocodilians. Spinosaurus was the last of its kind. It was really good at what it did, but the problem is the world changed around it, and Spinosaurus and its lineage didn't adapt. The adaptations of Spinosaurus, including its gigantic size, made it really successful when times were good. But when times changed and the environment changed around it, what had been an advantage turned into a liability, and its size and its specializations were just the wrong thing for that environment. It was too big to survive anymore.